Every 37 seconds, someone is arrested for possession of marijuana. Since 2010, state and local police have arrested an estimated 7.3 million Americans for violating marijuana laws, over half of all drug arrests. Black people are four times more likely to be arrested for marijuana laws than white people.
Welcome back. That is the controversial ad from Louisiana Senate candidate Gary Chambers. So we couldn't show it on daytime TV, but I'm sure you could put it together that he is smoking pot. The viral ad has been viewed more than 6 million times on Twitter, and Gary is with us to talk all about it.
Yes,
welcome to DBL.
Yes,
hey,
yes.
Hey.
Thank you for having me.
It is our honor. Okay, so your team came to you with the concept for the ad. Why did you think this approach was the right idea?
Well, we thought that it would give us the opportunity to cut through the noise and talk about Louisiana, the state that is ranked 50th in the nation in crime and 50th and 49th in opportunity, to give an opportunity for the rest of the country to say that jailing people for cannabis is not working. And here's an example, because we rank worst in the nation in crime.
So what reaction locally are you getting over the ad? Has it alienated any of your base, or have you grown followers from this?
Actually, we've probably shocked a whole bunch of people in a positive way. 68% of Louisianans believe that cannabis should be legalized for recreational use in this state. And that's Democrats, Republicans, black and white. And so when you see this, I think that many people in this state found it refreshing, the same way that many people around the country did. Everybody doesn't have to be a cannabis user in order to say that this isn't something that should be illegal, or that's something that people should be penalized for in any way.
All right. Well, you know, first of all, what's up, Gary? We're glad you're here. Appreciate you, bro. You know, we're here in Colorado, so marijuana is almost normalized at this point for us. But there's a lot of states that are watching right now where it's not normal. So people are going to look at your ad and be like, all right, that's a stunt. You're not serious about what you're doing. Talk to that person that would say that. What would you say to somebody that said this is a stunt and you're not serious?
I'd say that if I've got to smoke a blunt to kick these facts about the fact that I live in a state that ranks 46 in healthcare, 48 in education, 49 in environmental quality, 49 in the economy, 50th in crime, that's what it takes to make people pay attention to what's happening in this state, and that we have a U.S. senator who has failed to do his job in bringing resources back to the state of Louisiana, and that our state doesn't have to be married to one industry. We must diversify our economy, grow the economy, so that daughters like my little girl can grow up in Louisiana and live out their wildest dreams instead of moving to other places.
Be a good thing to say.
Yeah.
As well said.
Yes, thank you, Gary. So I want to talk, as Al just alluded to, you know, we're in Colorado. It's been legal here since 2012. So we're moving up on a decade. But in terms of decriminalization, that is a completely separate issue, especially when we're talking from state to state and federal. So why is this such an important issue? And has anyone you know been personally affected by the current marijuana laws?
Yes, I've had a friend who is an elected official here in Louisiana. And right before he was elected, there was a news story about his son had an arrest of simple possession of marijuana. That son no longer lives in Louisiana, lives in California, and is actually a business owner in the cannabis industry now, right? Something that he was penalized for in the state of Louisiana, he is in California making a living, providing for his family for in California. That is the disparity. That is the issue, that people can go and make a profit in one state, and in another state, you can seek criminal penalty and your livelihood be stripped away from you. And that is unjust, and it is inequitable, and it happens at an alarming rate for black people, even though black and white people use cannabis at about the same rate.
Great information. Listen, you ran for Congress last year. Now, what makes you think that this is going to be different this time around, that you're going to actually take home the win?
Well, one, I'm sitting on this show talking to you.
That's, right.
That's something we didn't do in the last campaign. The ability for us to win this election is real. We are much like Georgia in our demographics. We're the second blackest state in America. And we have a Democrat as our governor, though he is disappointing us with the handling of the Ronald Green case right now. This state has the potential to be the same as Georgia, because the numbers are there and we've already elected a Democrat. The difference now is that instead of having a small gerrymandered district to compete in, we have the entire state of Louisiana to talk about hope and progress and change that we can make for the people of this state. And I believe that we're going to get that message out there and do just what Georgia did and elect a black senator from the state of Louisiana.
Gary, thank you so much for joining us on DBL. If you'd like to learn more about what Gary stands for, visit chambersforlouisiana.com. Appreciate you.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Thank you.